Well, Dow, sir, probably an understatement to say it was a bad day at the office today.
Aye, very much so. Bit shocked actually, with the performances, but crowd got a bit of Murn. I know I shouted back at them because a couple of times at Murn's corner because I wanted them to come back at me, really, because I was shouting to get Rossi off and things like that. Whatever happens, I keep saying the shouts are justified, but can't be shouting, but they got. But but listen, we've got quite a main team. I picked the players, and I picked every single one of them players in that dressing room, and my responsibility. And all week I've been very positive about the whole outcome. But the desire to win a football game, which Concord showed today, and desire to the big lad up top to batter me centre halves, and their two centre halves having an easy day at the office, if you like, is a bit the way that went into it and the physicality of it, you know. And it was no good me complaining about my recruitment or the loan signings, which everybody's got to have a knock. I've got to take full responsibility for it because that's my side we've just put out there. In the last 12 years, when I've won things and I've been close like we are this season, I've always had like a few characters and a few diggers in there. I didn't see that today, but again, we're going to have a game Monday. We've got to dust ourselves down and get on with it.
And you must have been perhaps shocked really at the way Woking started, because right from the outset, the tempo wasn't there, was it?
Especially when you've just had that long journey to Truva. I know I went, but if you've had that long journey there, and you know, I really thought we'd come out of the traps quick. I thought we'd be, you know, but frankly, it started off on the first couple of minutes, as you said, and got steadily worse. And you know, we needed somebody in midfield to put a foot in the ball and maybe pass it, or a fullback to pass it. Us was said about as hot, it's ridiculous that we're going to whack a ball up the lure, but at times it was like just kicking out the player. I know confidence is a big thing in football, and because you know, we said at half time, of course, the supporters are going to have a crack at you, they're going to crack at me, rightly so. But the only thing you've got to do is get on with it, and we'll put it right on Monday. We can, and you know, I just look on thinking, you know, a very disappointing day all round, and I can understand people's frustrations, I really can.
And the other thing I think perhaps that was there to see today was obviously, you know, players will make mistakes, things will happen, but collectively you would expect the team to sort of rally around and roll up their sleeves and say, right, we're going to put this right, we're going to do something about it. And that nothing. Didn't seem out there at
no.
all. There was no one doing that.
Right, it didn't seem out to me either, to be honest. You know, it's just, you can talk as much as you like in there, and you can talk tactics as much as you like, but we've got it spot on because we knew what team we would play. And you can go at half time and be on them a bit or praise them a bit, or at the end there saying, come on. But somewhere along the line, somebody's got to take the lead in there and do it together. And I've said that, you know, I even had me captain out last week to say, come on, you've got to get into the troops a bit and all the rest of it. And it's a thing I think we're lacking, and we've lacked for the last 6 weeks. And not so much a leader, but the togetherness and all that, you know. And I've got some players who have been in the pro game playing forward, and I've got players who have been playing at a league up playing forward. And you're thinking, come on, somebody's sure, got to show something. Like, you know, Hodgie, I know he's been away and all the rest of it, but to be fair, he was our best player when he come on, wasn't he? And all that, so I got to admit, he's been away for the last 10 days. And you're thinking, if he's come on and he got on the ball and got with a penalty, because what we were, you know, then I'm just looking at across the board, really. So obviously, I'm a massive down at a day. I'll take any stick going because, like you see, I've signed every single player in there. With the backing of the board on transfer deadline day as well. So recruitment is down to me because I sign them. So yeah, I'll be on here when the times were great and all that, you know, so I've got to be in the times were not so good, but we're still in this. We've still got another, you know, week to go. We've got to dig in and all that, you know, and I've been thinking very confident all week, and but seeing that today, you're looking and thinking, Craig, there's some things not right in that dress room and all that, you know, we've got to get them kicked out as quick as we possibly can.
And did you think when you pull the goal back that there was every chance that you might go on and get at least an equaliser?
You do, but you do it very well, do it, keep everybody behind the ball and sort of counter attack you and slow the clock down and all of that, and you know, you look at that and you're thinking, you know, but people are saying the fouls, a big kid up wall, I think it's an excellent player, and you know, he's got to hold a cookie in the first half through with Miles, done the same with Casey in the second, whack Moose out of the way, and I think that's a good player made by a centre forward who's got that aggression. He's had this shoulder problem, he's popped it back in and played, it's come back out, he's popped it back in. And you look at it, you're thinking, you would die for something like that, really, you know, and stuff where you look at, maybe he's our lads complaining, there's a little niggle here and a little foot there and a hamstring here and a calf there. And I've heard that all season, really. So when I look further ahead and all that, you know, it's a character side of it, maybe at this time today I haven't got right, we're having less character in the team because we need somebody to stand up and be counted. I will, and I'm sure the staff will, but we just need the players too as well. But they're all my players, and I thought they were going to be better than that today and haven't been.
I mean, because it is extraordinary, because only 2 weeks ago you played against Torquay, yep. Before that you played against Bath, put in really, really good performances, and yet today was the complete opposite.
Complete opposite. Ian was said that you're a half time, saying, listen, let me still come on my head, go and get the ball, go and pass the thing, go and play and try to be exciting. And you're looking, you know, in the first 10 seconds in the second half, we've got work, we're going to get the ball out with feet quick enough, and you're thinking, that's 10 seconds in what we're saying to you. So, obviously, instructions aren't sinking in. And we'll have a look at it on Monday and see where we are there. And, you know, but I've got no excuses. Listen, I wish I could probably apologise to the supporters, really, because it must be hard paying that money and seeing we're having a little bit of a slump. But I hope I stick with it. I really do. I know we're well in one, so we need to win a couple of games now just to where we want to be. So I've got that as well. So listen, I've got no excuses whatsoever. I've just got to take
it. Is it a good thing that you're playing so quickly with a game coming up on Monday?
I hope so, but we thought it was a good thing them travelling down to Truro and having not all that long travel, but coming here, but the way the game looked, it's a physicality what we struggled on. And I think even the first header, the game we sent half lost a man in the first header. All the things we've been talking about where we know teams are going to come here and put balls in the box against them. So, it's a good thing, yes, we've got to play it. And listen, I can't make any more excuses, can I? You know, and I've been saying we'll be all right, and then we will be. And but what more excuses can I make? I can't. I've signed every single one of them players. I haven't been given us. They haven't been from last season's relegation. They've been my players I've signed purely on loan. They've been my players I sent them out to play that way. I've told them what to do and stuff I have. I told them to be excited because the crowds will build up. I've got whatever enthusiasm I possibly can in it and things like that. So what more can I say? I can't blame the players anymore. I can't. I've got to have a look at myself because the players are doing what I tell them to do. So if that's what I've told them to do, I've got to take full responsibility. So I'm not paying for nothing. Bottom line is I'll stick my chest out on Sunday. I'll probably get a bit of stick in the bar now, rightly so, but I'll still do my talk up there. And I think I should. But the bottom line is we've been beaten by a better side who are more physical than us and wanted it more than us on the day. I've got no excuses at all.
And finally, Alan, are you confident still that Woking can finish second?
Yeah, we've got to win these two games. Obviously, it gets two sides who are, on in the top six. We'll go win them two games and I still think we'll get promoted, yeah. You can shoot us down with flames, but I still think we'll win.
Lovely, thank you very much for your time.
No problem. Thank you.